The Mitre 10 Cup, brought to you by Mitre 10.
A clash between neighbours at Ecolite Stadium in Pukekohe as Counties Manukau take on Waikato in the Premier Division of the Mitre 10 Cup. The Steelers just 2 points off the lead now after their win over their other neighbours, Auckland at Eden Park last week, while Waikato are just behind them in fourth, but coming off a tough defence at the Ranfurly Shield last weekend. In fact, it's been tough going for both of these teams. Counties Manukau coming off a very busy stretch of game. Waikato, of course, the Shield match. They won that, but they've lost a few players. Damien McKenzie and Tawhata Kerr-Barlow to the All Blacks. Lonnie O'Hela, Jordan Munihira, Jacob Skeen amongst those on a growing injury list. Tyler Campbell stays at fullback, promising debut from him last week. Seva Reese on the wing looks a dazzling young prospect. Harrison Levine takes over at halfback, and quite a reshuffle in the forward pack as well for Waikato. Former All Blacks Stephen Bates is with me. Stephen, tough challenge for Waikato against this very good county side, although it's getting to that time of the season, isn't it, when the injuries are starting to bite.
Yeah, it is, and the Mulu side have had a lot of injuries, have had a lot of change, but in saying that, you're still putting a quality side out there tonight, and it should be a great game of football to watch.
Counties Manukau coming off a win over Auckland, which they'll cherish. Another short turnaround for them. Minimal changes though by coach Darryl Suasua. Big Matiaha Martin comes back in at lock in place of Matt Va'ai, goes back to the bench. Jimmy Tupou switches to blindside flanker. A settled looking back line built around that excellent combination of Augustine Pulu and Piers Francis. And some big news on the bench. Puliasi Manu finally back from the Achilles injury that he suffered way back in March. Well, conditions for this game now on a Friday night. Richard Turner is sideline.
Yeah, thanks, Tony. Evening, Stephen. Evening, all. It's actually, when we arrived, there was a bit of breeze floating around. That seems to have gone. It's going to be heavy underfoot because there's been a bit of rain around in Pukekohe this week, so that might be the only real issue. I can tell you, fellas, that Counties Manukau have won the toss and have chosen to play right to left as we're looking at it.
Well, it's a milestone game for Sam Christie tonight, coming out at the head of the Waikato side, his 50th. And so he has the honour of leading the team out. They have had a late change with Leva Fifita in for Brian Alainuese, who's been ruled out of this match. So another disruption to the team. They make that long walk down the tunnel here at Pukekohe, having made a short trip up State Highway 1. Probably took them about half the time it took us to get here from Auckland. A nice moment coming out in front of this, as always, enthusiastic crowd here at Pukekohe. Important points on offer tonight, and they've brought a few fans with them as well. On an unbeaten run of four games since dropping their opener to the Marcos. They did draw that Shield game, of course, last week. But that's all they needed to keep the log of wood. Seva Reese was in blistering form again last week. This 19-year-old Fijian out of Hamilton Boys High, first 15. Well, the Steelers going along pretty well. Three wins, three losses, but greatly buoyed by their first win at Eden Park in 40 years of trying. All of their games tend to be pretty close. They've got bonus points from their losses. You can see there's a tough run coming up. Waikato, then Tasman, then Canterbury. The youngsters enjoying the opportunity to get nice and close to their heroes. Jordan Taufua, outstanding player, this fellow. Plays his 50th national championship game tonight. Gives great value every time he steps out, no matter who he's playing for or against. Referee for tonight's match from Taranaki is Cameron Stone. He'll be assisted by Anthony Petrie and Nigel Bradley from Counties Monaco. Glenn Blackwell is the TMO. And as usual, good moment for a young fella. This young man here from the Pukekohe under eight Sharks. Good on you, Lachlan. He'll enjoy that. He's taking his task pretty seriously.
Are we good to go, Nigel?
So it'll be the Steelers. Counties Manukau away to our left in the first half. Nice clear night here in Pukekohe.
Gold.
And another intense weekend of Mitre 10 Cup rugby about to start. Oh, Piers Francis, one of the form players in the New Zealand competition, gets us underway, kicking down towards the 22, and a good follow-up too from Sherwin Stowers to get hands to it. But he's knocked the ball on, so the referee will play advantage here. Ratuva, the right winger for Waikato, is bringing it under control, and they'll look to work it out. Mitch Jacobson, early touch for him. Now the kick from Harrison Levine. And Monaco looking to bring it back. And a pick and go from Jimmy Tupou. So an early touch for Laulala, the fullback. Now the forwards will take it over. Big Toi Loma. Now Talfour. Ferocious fend that he's got. Taken by his opposite number, Jacobson. Pulu sniping, gets a nice ball away. Well, almost got a nice ball away to Fa'asoo, the number eight, but it's been turned over. Levine kicks away downfield. Francis is there, fires it infield. Here's Laulala. Stowers now. Now Carter Vainga ranging out wide. Just getting a little close to the touchline, Stowers. But it's there for Augustine Pulu. Now carting it forward, Toi Loma, big powerful fellow. Suat, the hooker, moves it on. Rarasea. Enjoying plenty of ball in the early stages here. Counties Manukau. Francis now onto Fa'asoo. Now a bit of space for Fifita. Sione Fifita on the right wing. Behind the back, nicely collected by Francis. And now the picker go. Talfua steaming ahead with it. Again, Jacobson has to tackle, and they've got them on the back foot now. So Counties Manukau straight onto the attack, and it's Toi Loma handles for the third time in this long phase of play, and he gets the opening try. Kalolo Toi Loma, the man they call the bulldozer.
And it's great, isn't it, TJ? Early on, what we see is going to be a problem for Waikato all night. County's big forwards rumbling over the advantage line, rumbling over the advantage line, getting in behind the defence here. We see lovely bit of handling as well. He set a ruck here, and then just from here, the forwards just take over. And from there, a big man like that, he's pretty hard to stop, crashes over under the posts.
Well, it was Sean Botherway's big concern coming into this match. He said our defence will have to be very good against this Counties Manukau side. Those fears have been realised early on in this contest. Counties Manukau continuing where they left off on Wednesday. A very good performance. The conversion for Piers Francis is a gimme. And Counties Manukau, the perfect start in front of their home fans.
Well, there he is, Kalolo Toi Loma from the champion Bombay club. He works for a demolition company. Well, he's done a nice demolition job on the defence, featuring several times in the build-up to the try. And just to start, Waikato didn't want this game sandwiched in between two big Shield games. So the restart floating down, oh, and not taken cleanly by Fa'asoo. Toi Loma says, I got this. But there he is. Been making waves, this fellow. Sootala Fa'asoo spent last year playing in the Heartland Championship with Wairarapa Upper Bush. He was a star at school at St. Kentigan's and just starting to really make his presence felt in the top division now.
He is, and the thing about him what impresses me too, he's a big ball carrier, but he also gets through a lot of defensive work. The Mulu didn't start very well, but he's a perfect opportunity to in the launch and get themselves into the game.
Crouch.
See Sebu Reese parked outside on the right, Bind. Left shoulder of Sam Christie, so he's looking to get involved from this set piece.
Well, he's one of those players, Richard Turner. that people watching just want to see the ball in his hands as much as possible.
Now crouch position, head and shoulders clearly above hips.
There's certainly
head and shoulders clearly above hips.
A lot of chat involving Severis, Tony, so I'm picking he's either asking to be involved or being told to be involved, but either way, as you say, exciting player when he's got ball in hand.
Crouch.
And there he is, Sevu Reese, just 19 years of age, electrifying player.
Set.
Keep an eye on him, but blinking, you'll miss him.
Well, talked about the underfoot conditions might be slightly heavy for these guys. It's a fair bit of rain about.
Is that Mark?
Tokukoi, and build up to this. No rain right now, it's been clear, and I think most of this game, if not all of it, will be played.
Guys, we want an outcome first scrum,
in the clear, but two big forward packs going head to head, two big front rows, so they need plenty of purchase underneath them, these forward packs. And they might not get that tonight.
Well, Tui Loma packing down against
Crouch.
Latu Talakai on this side of the scrum.
Buying. Set.
This time, and it goes under a bit of pressure too, but they get it away to Levine, and here's Tofui, the number 12, charging through the middle. So Waikato, opportunity to strike back straight away. Levine fires it out, and they'll look to ram home the advantage.
Red release.
So Levine, they want it quickly away on the right. They go close, very close. And the referee says we'll scrum it. So it was a good hit up from Josh Yosefa Scott. And he got them on the front foot. Talakai held up close to the line, so they'll have a scrum.
Also, like Tony, Levine's getting in there quickly, clearing the ball to the Mulu forwards who are coming round the corner. You know, they're up against it, a very sizable weight advantage up against them tonight, but also a good little bit of confidence booster there to get over the gain line and get quick, clear ball.
Let's go, guys.
So, Levine, New Zealand age group halfback. You can see Fetu Douglas, the captain.
Crouch.
Clapping, trying to get some urgency going. They've got a good opportunity here. Reese.
Set.
Wide out on the left-hand side. Of course, danger to Hulahollo, 13. Tyler Campbell, you can see the fullback there up in the line. The young man. He's come across from Australia. Made a good debut last week. You can see there in the number 15 jersey. Halaholo's gone in, had a word. Tofui inside him. First scrum came under a bit of pressure though.
Latu Talakai on the loose head here for Waikato. Got a big task tonight against Kalolo Tui Loma.
Bind.
And the front row goes down, but Levine fires it away. Christie trying to weave his way through. Referee orders up a penalty. Is getting in front of the ball carrier. And so an opportunity to really apply some more pressure comes to nothing. And it'll be a clearance for touch from Piers Francis.
Yeah, a little disappointing there because they had a good platform to work from. They just didn't communicate. They just got the communication a little bit wrong. And you see here, I'm not sure the pass was meant to go there. Just a little bit of lack of communication running in behind and a fair instruction, fair enough.
Yeah, certainly, Stephen, the acknowledgement from Sam Christie when he got to his feet that there might have been a bit of a communication breakdown.
But I see it. Takes it at the line out. Pulu thumps it high. Dowers might have got a bit of a head start in the chase. Off, brilliantly taken, though, by Ratuva. There's some real class on both wings here. Levine went beyond his skipper. Christie with the kick.
It's taken back.
Francis stayed back. He'll just kick long, try and drive them downfield. Christie dropped back to the 22 to take it. Big pass across field. And here's Ratuva, the chip into a bit of space too, but it sits up nicely. Well read by Pulu. Runs hard into Jacobson. And trying to hack it through there was Favard. Now it has been hacked ahead by Waikato, but I think 14. Someone might have been offside.
Offside.
Yeah, Ratuva the winger.
To be fair to Waikato there, the ball did actually look like it came out, but I think they were offside originally, so a fair enough penalty. And a chance for Counties just to go deep inside the Waikato's half and get their big forwards into the game again, get them coming around the corner and punching those close channels.
On your side.
So Francis just wearing the headgear, still protecting that nasty ear injury that he suffered. But finds a good touch just inside the 22.
Key moment here for the Waikato defense. They've really got to stand up. You know, if they want to have a chance, they've got to really stand up and say we're here to play in the close quarters now.
And Martin goes back as a lifter, lifts Talfo, and here is Pulu. Stowers. Good tackle made by Ratuva, though. But they've still got a way on to a look. He's got a double.
Is it a day? Is it a weekend for the front rowers, Tony? We saw a hat-trick last night. Are we going to see a hat-trick tonight? The big man crashes over his second inside 11 minutes.
He's given himself every chance.
But I wonder here off the back of the line out, maybe they've noticed something. They just exploit the back of the tail from Waikato. They get over the gain line. The ruck ball's reasonably quick here. And then after that, it's just quick, slightly on the outside. And from that position, you're not going to stop a man of that size.
Yeah, Waikato boys blowing up a little bit, asking referee Stone the question about whether he impeded their ability to defend from the tail of that line out, but I think Counties Manukau, they just had too much momentum. Pulu's real strength, his acceleration into open spaces. Shu and Stowers on the inside, and well, how about Kalolo Tuiloma?
So Carlos, the bulldozer, has two. Piers Francis trying to convert from right out on the touchline, and well, that's the worst kick of his season, possibly anyone's. Let's have a look at it again, see if you can spot any obstruction here.
Jacobson there, and then again there, but look, I think they're too far gone by that stage, so no issues for me, Tony.
So, not so much obstruction, they were complaining about the ref getting in the way. Ref Richard.
Yeah, a couple of the defenders trying to cover, having to go around the referee, but as I said, I think Count is well and truly on the front foot by that stage.
Another deep restart. Here's Fa'asoo. See, Leva Fafita, the late replacement into the side. He's the man making the tackle. Been lost forward, so I've got to get an opportunity here. And it is Fafita taking it round the side. Therefore, Levine. Jacobson with the carry. Now, Josefa Scott. The tight head prop's gone and a bit high, though. And it's been ripped away by Radosea. The lock for the Steelers comes out for Pulu. Realised they'd crept up a bit. And oh, Jordan Talfua tries a kick. Finds a bit of land, too. Bounces awkward, but it's been grabbed by Sebu Reese. He's getting some numbers there. Opportunity to walk over it, no.
Around the side seven.
Fair enough, Tafua just comes around the side there, but to me, Waikato just look a little bit lethargic. Maybe the big Ranfurly Shield game last weekend is starting to catch up to them a little bit, but they need to, now with Christy here, he'll put the ball deep into territory, and they need to start to stamp their authority on the game a little bit, otherwise it's going to be a long evening for them.
Yeah, been given a couple of opportunities from the restart, from errors from Fasor. And here we see Rarasea doing some very good work in the tight, just rips the ball clear and says, I'm off.
So, I mean, Favor with the throw.
Just make sure you set the gap. I've asked both of you guys to set the gap. Can you bring your guys down, please? Bring your guys down. Red! Stop. Red.
Hasn't been,
come down.
Been the best part of their game. The line out for Waikato only operating at 77% efficiency. Plenty of work to do there.
Yeah, and that's not a good one either. Just overthrown a bit. And I think there might have been a little knock on in there from County. So they get the initial call, which is crook line out throw. Yeah, it's gone right down their side. Still couldn't take it at the back. Fetu Douglas.
Just worrying signs for Waikato here. As Pod, you've just mentioned, now they've had three chances just outside the County's 22, and they've given away possession pretty easily three times. County's only been down the other end twice, and they've picked up two tries. So worrying for Waikato early.
Interesting to see you've got Adam Byrne, blindside flanker, packing down at number eight, defensive scrum. Fetu Douglas on the side. And that's a big pack. County's Manukau pack is big and strong. Well, he's getting his name up in lights tonight, hasn't he?
Well, that's
Kalolo Tuiloma.
It's a great adjustment to County's Manukau. They lost the contact initially. The shove came from Waikato, and then they made the adjustment and came straight back at them. And he's a big bloke, Kalolo Tuiloma. And he is certainly delivering every kilo out there at the moment. You see the initial engaged count. Waikato got this there. They got the hit. County's absorbed it and then gave it straight back to them. Deserves all the applause.
County's win it. Cleared away by Fa'asau'u. Strong straight run from Sam Vaka, the centre. Now Jimmy Tupou. Waikato coming under a lot of pressure here. Pulu, nice short ball away to Fa'asau'u. Makes metres. Very good. And here's Tuiloma again. This time over the 22 he goes. Pulu comes away. Talfua wheeling out of the tackles. Talfua taken 5 metres short. Oh, he's gone for the line again. And he's got a hat-trick. Unbelievable. Kalolo Tuiloma, the prop, scores a hat-trick in 16 minutes.
Well, as I said, Tony, it's a weekend for the front rowers. He can do it in 16. But, you know, Waikato's coach, Tom, by the way, his biggest fears are being realised. He said early on that the big County's forwards are getting around the corner. Started by Talfua here, and then after that, twice in a row, they just switched that to the blind side, and here he is here, just crashing over again. Almost a carbon copy of his first, of his second.
Oh, Waikato just guilty of their first up tackles not being made, and that's allowing counties to get on the front foot, and they've got so many dangers, so many good ball carriers, and players now encouraged to stay in support of the ball carrier because there's every opportunity, every chance they're going to get an offload. This one a little less challenging for Piers Francis.
Well, Brian McGrattan, I think the last prop to score a hat-trick in a championship match back in 1984. And that is a feat that has been equaled by this man here, Kalolo Tuiloma, his third try. He's smashing them at scrum time. He's dealing to them round the field. He's got three tries, and County's Manukau lead by 19-0. And that expression hasn't changed. Fa'asau'u. Well, they're going a point a minute here. County's Manukau. Pulu, little chip ahead. Sits up nicely, though, for Fetu Douglas. And now here's Tyler Campbell, this exciting young fullback. He really more used to playing in the number 10 jersey. And well, now Talakai says, I don't want to be left out of the action. The front row extravaganza that we're seeing here tonight. Josefa Scott couldn't take that, but the ball wasn't lost forward. Now they get a penalty.
Entry and off your feet. Entry, off your feet.
And here we go. Here's a chance. This is going to go deep into the 22, and Waikato get a chance to assert a bit of pressure onto Counties. They've had a couple of chances down here early on. They've given up position fairly easily. Now it's a, now they've to establish themselves in the game, they've got to get into it at the 20-minute mark.
Oh, Faifa, last time they got down here, the throw wasn't on the mark. Oh, worried looks on the faces of these Waikato players. It was always going to be a difficult game, this. Coming in between their defence against Taranaki. They've got one coming up mid through next week against Canterbury. But important points at stake here. When you look at the table, Counties Manukau third, Waikato fourth, Auckland just a breath behind them. And again, doesn't find the target. Pulu kicks ahead, tears after it, showing good speed too. Nicely mopped up by Campbell at the back, but he's under pressure, left to deal with it on his own. Eventually it comes out. Byrne fires the pass away. And the kick floated down to Fifita. It's Sione Fifita. He's a little bit short. And Josefa Scott's done well, the tight end prop for Waikato. Get in there and pick the ball up. Pops out to Levine. Away it goes to Christie. Fires the pass. And it's bounced up. Here's Campbell. And he's thrown it away. Sam Vucker forced over the touchline with it. So just when they get opportunities, Waikato just looking a bit untidy. Here's Tyler Campbell there in shot.
He's gone and chucked the ball away. Makes sense to me.
They've got a penalty here for throwing the ball away, but you're right, Tony. Waikato at the moment, they just look a little bit shell-shocked. They're not sure. They're perhaps lacking a little bit of direction. They just need to have a settling play, get their forwards into the game at the moment, and everything's happening a little bit too quickly for them at the moment.
Well, Tatavanga was looking up and not at the player he was wanting to tackle. Might have had a better opportunity for an intercept, and then Vucker biffs the ball into the embankment here, so can't Waikato the opportunity from line out. It's been a bit wobbly the last two.
Oh, Fetu Douglas says, I got this, the captain.
One.
Driven back by Counties. Now they start to get it edging forward. Well, that's fallen to bits a bit. And they've lost it. Turnover. Just can't take a trick at the moment, Waikato.
No, they can't. And they have some exciting backs, Waikato. But at the moment, their forward pack, defence and attack, are just getting absolutely monstered. And if your forward pack's not going to stand up, they're not going to be in for a chance. But Counties just all over them. Look at this. They're all in. Heads are down. Filing them back. The Waikato heads are up. They're all over the place. A poor maul. And as I said at the moment, Counties pack are just all over the Waikato pack at the moment.
Well, no chat, Stephen, for me, amongst the Waikato forwards, and clearly that lack of communication telling there on a couple of times. Players twos and threes breaking out of that, driving more, so no awareness of where the ball is, no awareness of what's going on around them.
Well, there's been some great matches between these unions. I think we've got a notable one coming up tonight if Tui Luma keeps going the way he is. But take you back to 1997. Afa Leo in the front row, saw him earlier on tonight, but here's, well, a brilliant Counties team in action. George Laupepe here, remember him, and you'll sure as heck remember the bloke outside him, Joely Vendiri. He was in amazing form in that game. They came from 27-8 down and then 37-15 down to beat Waikato. That was in the semi-finals of the National Championship in 1997.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Tony, but I think the ground announcer that day had already announced that sales for the final will be on sale on Monday.
It was an absolutely brilliant comeback.
Set!
Memory serves, I think they played Canterbury in the final. Just couldn't go the extra step. And here's that big scrum again. Carlos, the bulldozer driving. Pulu looks up, and well, very confident, and sensing an opportunity to run it out to his Fifita. with the fend or Reese stuck to him well. Did well on defence. We know he's a good attacking player.
Just another show of power by the county scrum, though, wasn't it? But also not only the power, then the ability to look up and play what's in front of them. Perhaps should have tried to stay in, but they saw space and tried to use the space.
Yeah, that flashback, you know, that brings back all sorts of memories, but obviously painful ones for some, including our good friend Matthew Cooper, who's just broken out into a cold sweat watching at home in Hamilton. Memories of that day. Waikato have it. And look to get it wide too to Willis Halaholo. Floats the ball away to Ratuva. And he's in at the corner, is he? No. Referee will have to have a check here. No flag on the far side. Waikato celebrating a try. Well, I don't know what the assistant thinks.
They need to check this, Tony.
He was miles away.
Yeah, first of all, he was a long way away, the assistant referee.
Timo Glennie there.
And then, initially, when he was grounded, he was on his back.
Can we just check two things? The last pass was okay, and then, obviously, grounding and whether he's over the white line, thanks, or the sideline.
I'm not sure if he got there or not, obviously. That's twice now that Waikato has broken down the left-hand side of the county's defence. So when they can get a little ball, a good quality ball from their forwards, their backs are showing that they can attack. Let's have a look.
Well, it was a great pass from Halaholo. And I think they'll rule that's gone backwards out of the hand. I'm not sure there's such a problem with that. I think it's the... This last bit here, he's sliding a long way out. He's got this down before going out. This is a pretty good effort. Oh, I think he's in touch there, isn't he?
Yeah, that was the concern for me, Tony, that it took him a while. He landed and then rolled, bounced onto his back and then had to ground the ball. This should be the shot that Waikato fans probably don't want to see.
Yeah, he's in touch, I'm sure, by the time he's grounded that. Big tangle of legs. Oh, Waikato really need this. They've gone back to halfway, as they all do.
I think that's the standard these days, isn't it, Tony?
So there's no reason you can't award the try, so the try stands. Thank you. No reason not to award the try, so the try stands.
Try it is.
And great reward, and it's what the game needed, wasn't it? You know, all of a sudden, Waikato have got a chance down the county's left edge, and they've taken it. Here we go. They just get in behind here. Great ball, and just slightly outnumbered. It's show and go, and then we just give it. And then a little bit of pace. Great chase, great commitment, but he crashes over in the end and breathes a little bit of life into the Waikato team.
Well, it comes down to two questions that can be asked. One, give me a reason not to award the try or no try. So... the question was, can you give me any reason he couldn't, because he couldn't see whether Ratuva had crossed the line, so fair call.
Well, fair call from the TMO. I guess the only question is, did he ask the right question? And that's a difficult one. No luck with the kick, but Liesa Ratuva gets Waikato on the board. Lovely break from Willis Halaholo. And a lovely pass out in front, too, of Ratuva. There's pretty illustrious support staff up there. Roger Randall in the middle of the shot. Carl Hoft away to the right. And Sean Honick, the line-out coach, in the background.
Plenty of experience up there.
So it's 19-5. And Waikato managed to stop the bleeding with a try by this man here, Liesa Ratuva. After that storming start by County's Manukau, kicked by Christie. a good one too. Well, it's good to see him back playing with Waikato. He's done a bit of globetrotting. He played over in Australia for a while, went off further afield.
For me, absolutely key 5 to 10 minutes here for the Waikato team. They need to stand up. Counties are going to put their big ball carriers at them again, but it's time to stand up, time to make a contest and say they mean business. Key 10-minute period coming up.
So Nafatasi Sua. And well, that one's been overthrown. It's been grabbed by Mitch Jacobson for Waikato. So just starting to come back into the game a little bit here. Yosefa Scott rather squirts out. Here's Douglas. Stopped by Tupou. Now Levine away to Favour. Homie Favour. Inside the half they go. Campbell, the fullback. Now Levine away to Fifita. And we've got a penalty here.
Well, seven kicking the ball.
Good
and
continuity down by the Waikato team. You know, first time they put a bunch of phases together, 8-9 phases together, and they get a just reward. They get a shot at goal, and as you said, Tony, all of a sudden they seem to just be working their way into the game after the initial onslaught by Counties Manukau.
Yeah, and just the difference points on the board makes in terms of your mindset now. Waikato happy to now inside enemy territory to collect any points. So, pretty much out in front. The distance is the challenge here.
So, Sam Christie, first kick was from wide out. This one, well, maybe just to the right of the uprights. Left foot kicker. Nice still conditions. You know, plenty on it, but he has hooked it away to the right of the post. Another 3 points there, just eating into that lead a little bit more. As it is, it's 19-5. Look at that combination just standing there, Pulu and Francis. A lot of talk that might be the 9 and 10 for the Blues. Of course, Ehire West also next year, so they've got some options there. With a lot of star quality outside them. Now Rees. Campbell puts it high. As Talfour came at him. And taken nicely by Laulala. Campbell trying to get a hold of him, but he's wrestled away from it by one of the other Counties Manukau players. Now the chip kick ahead from Sherwin Stowers. He found a bit of space in behind them too. But back there is Harrison Levine. And the young halfback. It's a long kick downfield. Counties Manukau look to get things going. Pulu, who's been in the middle of everything. Now here's Leva Fifita. The lock. And makes a run down the touchline, but he ends up running out of room. There he is, coming into the side late. And the kick's been taken quickly. Chance to run it back. And Christie putting the kick. And Laulala calling for the mark.
I just wondered down there, Pod, Waikato have come back into the game, and we obviously know Counties are a big physical pack. Is the tempo of the game starting to get to Counties a little bit?
Well, as I mentioned, Steve, the heavy underfoot as well. Waikato, they're clearly wanting to speed up the pace of the game, and yeah, I think it might be having a toll in terms of Counties Manukau having to defend for the last few minutes.
Well, Halaholo's kick acutely angled. And Pulu was back, and eventually he just puts it out into touch. And certainly, those tries came in a real rush at the start of the game. Different feel about the last 10 or so minutes.
Waikato all of a sudden just starting to get small victories. You know, coming into the game, both sides have had a big workload, but Counties, this is their fifth game in 19 days, maybe feeling the pinch a little bit halfway through the first half.
Certainly got the start they wanted for a team coming off such a tough schedule. Mate Waikato chased the game, but it's settled down a bit now. Line-out's working a little better too. Delivery not great to Levine from Douglas, but gets it away, although it might have been ripped off. I think Pulu's got in there, and he's ripped it away from Christie. Although he might get another turnover here back the other way. And he'll take it to ground. Oh, no. Well, it looked to me like Pulu had ripped that ball away and that scrum feed might go the other way, but not the case.
Obviously, the referee saw it differently. They saw his original maul. But under these new laws, I really like this. I really like this tactic that you use. You get under the ball carry, you get your ball carrier, you get your hips in, and you just try and keep the ball off the ground. But I do agree with you, Tony. Pulu might have had the ball there, but referee obviously saw it differently, so Counties will get this one.
It was a real feature of their performance on Wednesday against Auckland, Counties Manukau.
Just look for my way.
Their ability to get in and secure possession would have created probably three or four turnovers from creating mauls in the tackle situation.
Just having another look at that replay, I think he has made the right decision. Christie still had hold of the ball. Pulu might have been in a dominant position. Now look, there's that scrum drive again. Looking to perhaps pick up a penalty here. Well, lovely ball on a plate for Pulu. Runs, keeps running, and now Francis to the 22. He goes. Bit untidy, but Pulu so good at doing that. Now Fa'asoto.
Four offside.
So another penalty. This time it goes to Counties Manukau. Maybe a chance here for a settler for Piers Francis just to put one between the sticks, restore some of that advantage that they had early.
Yeah, I agree, Tony. They've pointed to the sticks already, but here, just the ball pops out the back here, but just another show of strength from the Counties pack, and also the skills to go with it. And maybe, as you said earlier, is that the Blues combination for next year? The boys are a little bit slow to get round. They eventually get the penalty, and it's just a chance for Counties just to settle the game down. As I mentioned, Waikato had a couple of small victories. Counties just a chance to settle it down.
Talk about that Blues combination. Of course, Ehire West played really well this year in tandem with this man, Piers Francis. I just think it gives them a great option that you could use one of them coming off the bench, a bit like the All Blacks have done with Bowden Barrett.
Exactly, and a guy like West, he has that attacking ability, you know, if he was to be on the bench and come on and spark things.
Well, Francis certainly wants the job, and his goal kicking is very good. And so, Counties Manukau get their first penalty of the night. It's 22 points to 5. Jordan Tafua in his 50th tonight. There's Mitch Jacobson. The two number sevens. And Pulu's kick is charged. Bounces up for him though, and eventually put over the touchline. There was some good pressure there. And it was young Reese who got up after that. Just the sight of Jordan Tafua in the number seven jersey. Stephen, of course, a loose forward yourself. It's something we're seeing under these new laws that you're not necessarily looking for a fetcher in that role anymore, are you?
No, not under these new rules. You want a ball carrier. You want a guy that can bust the line because the ruck is a lot more passive than it used to be.
And Tafua is certainly that. Oh, that's a bad mistake there. Adam Byrne was out in midfield. Ball bouncing away off his chest. And so quick hands here and a bit of space here for Laulala. Turns it back in field and, well, that's a knock-on. Bounced out of one set of Counties Manukau hands into another. And so they'll come back.
Oh, they don't need much encouragement, though, do they, this Counties Manukau side? Waikato, again, not able to sustain any pressure inside enemy territory. And then Counties just sends half an opportunity and off they go. Some good interchange down the short side. And then eventually keep it to hand. And almost on halfway, Waikato will have to build again on attack.
Not only powerful in the forwards, they've also got a lot of skill out wide as well. They complete package almost, Counties.
Set.
Oh. Waikato have been under constant pressure at scrum time in this game.
We're doing so well. Can we
Latu Talakai on this side has really got his hands full with Tui Loma.
Come up, here's your mark.
See Fiver in the middle and Josh Josefa Scott having his first start tonight for Waikato on the far side of the scrum. He's had one game off the bench.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Levine has a better scrum from Waikato that time. They bring Ratuva, their try scorer, in off the wing. Manages to smuggle it away, but look at that tigerish play from Talfua. Faivark comes away with it. Referee playing advantage. Good run here too from the Waikato hooker. Bustling down towards the 10-metre mark. Now away on the right, Christie moving it on. Halaholo, every time he touches the ball, you sense there's something on. Levine, nice delay away to Fifita. Like his brother, looks a real athlete. Now Josefa Scott, carry up towards the 22. Levine, dabbing and breaking through the first tackle. Not going to get past Pulu though. Such a good defender. Talakai now making a couple of good metres. All right, working their way up towards the line here. Josefa Scott has another carry. Making counties turn their hand to defence now. Faber, a nice little in pass.
Advantage is over.
Josefa Scott. Not really able to make any metres. Talakai and Levine now gets it away to his skipper Douglas. Levine again, Christie. Now they look to get it wide. Halaholo takes it to the line. Now Campbell took it under a bit of pressure and had to go into the tackle upright. And yeah, the referee, you heard him, he said release. It was a tackle. And just getting a little fractious here.
Hold, hold, hold. Walk away.
Well, the walk referee away. In there adjudged that a tackle had been made. They were trying to hold him up, but if his knees touched the ground, then they have to release him.
And the referee was clear. We all heard it. So the referee was clear in his ruling there, so they had to release him. But what I did like about the Waikato attack there, it's the first time they've got a little pick go, a little momentum. They sort of, a little bit of lack of communication here, but we'll see here. Originally, yes, they have got them held up. That's sure. There he is there. But we'll see here. His knees just go to good now. His knees have touched the ground. They need to release him. And they didn't release him. They kept on holding him up, thinking it was a maul turnover. Here we go.
Well, they've taken the tap. Haven't bothered going for the line out. It's been a little bit unreliable.
Use it.
Here's the chance. Waikato gets some more points on the board just before half time. Reduce some of that leeway.
Use it.
The counties had shot out to that 19-0 lead. Oh, Levine. Away it goes to Douglas. And move it on. Josefa Scott. Levine tried to get the pass away. And he's lost it.
Yep, disappointing for Levine there. They were building, weren't they? You could see that the backs had realigned and they're ready to sweep back to the open side of the field. But unfortunately, just the leg gets in the way. Little knock on. And right before halftime would have been great for the Mulus to close the gap, give them a bit of confidence just before the break.
Well, counties 5 metres from their own line. You'd think a formality, just get it in, get it out.
Nine.
Oh, what a half this man has had in the front row. Kalolo Tuiloma, a hat trick for the big tight head.
Fine.
He's been just as impressive in this facet of play here, Stephen Bates. Scrummaging. Yeah.
Yeah, dead right. He's got the Counties pack as a whole have got the Waikato pack at scrum time really under pressure, haven't they? A big weight advantage, and their hits has also most of the time been good. And then what I like is their second weight. They keep the ball in the back and they keep marching forward, making the Waikato backs retreat.
That expression, you wouldn't want to play poker against him. You would never know what he's holding. It just hasn't changed the whole game.
Bind. Set.
Come on, Waikato. Waikato trying to put some heat on. And nonchalantly moving it forward. And Pulu puts it dead. So that's halftime here at Ecolite Stadium in Pukekohe. And at the break, Counties Manukau leading Waikato by 22 points to 5. Willis Halaholo of Waikato with Richard Turner.
Oh, Willis, pretty tough first 40 minutes, eh?
Yeah, the Counties boys are coming out firing, beating us around the corner. I'll front row and I'll type 5, need to get more physical, I guess.
Work ons for the second half?
Just get more physical, make our tackles, and work hard around the corner, and we'll see.
Good luck with that.
See you, brother. Thanks.
So at halftime, a good lead for Counties Manukau, 22-5 over Waikato. Well, an astonishing start to this game here at Pukekohe, because we had a hat-trick inside the first quarter of the game from Kalolo Tuiloma, the tight head prop for Counties Manukau, and that's got them off to a 22-5 lead. Good build-up play here. In fact, it was a very good start, Stephen Bates, from the Counties Manukau team, and this man capitalised.
It was a great start, and the tries are obviously, the launch plays are slightly different, but the tries are virtually pretty similar. You know, it's just their big Counties forwards are just rolling over their advantage line, getting in behind, and from there it's too hard to stop. And that was number two.
And number three followed soon after. Again, Taufua involved. He really is just so dynamic with ball in hand. And here we go, Carlos the Bulldozer smashing over for try number three. Looks really excited about it. They did get one back. We thought there was a bit of doubt about this try, but it was a lovely break from Willis Halaholo. And Ratuva, well, they decided he didn't have a foot in touch. Let's take a look at the stats here, and those top two on the right reflect the dominance, the inability really of Waikato to get points on the board.
Yeah, and that's right. It's not so much how much time Counties are spending in the Waikato half, it's what they're doing when they're there. They're high energy, they're rolling over the top of the forwards, where Waikato on the other side of things are a little bit sloppy, a little bit undecisive.
So inside the Counties Manukau changing room, we'll have a chat with their assistant coach, one of their assistant coaches, Semel Satiti, very shortly. Grant Henson, the forwards coach, will be very happy with how things are going at scrum time. Both teams have had a few problems at line-out, but Waikato have had the biggest problem of the lot, trying to contain Kalolo Tuiloma and the big Counties Manukau forward pack. It's the home team leading at halftime, 22-5. Replacement Sione Faletau is on.
Red.
I've taken off Tuiloma. He apparently has gone off for a concussion test.
Yeah, Tony.
Which he's failed.
Yeah, confirm that he's failed the concussion test. So no records for the big fella tonight. And Waikato have made some replacements too.
Yeah, I don't know what the concussion test would have been. Asking who scored the tries for his team, if he got that wrong, but that's always something, of course, you've got to take the ultimate care over. And so it's sad that we're not going to see him again for the rest of the game, because he was unbelievable in the first half, but they've got a replacement on. Here's Severis, no real opportunities for him so far in the game. Had to do a fair bit of work going backwards. Can they get themselves back in the game? Looks like they've got a change too on the wing. Milford Kerasoma is on there, and it's his kick that's floated down to Piers Francis. Slips as he gets his kick away. So Ratuva spying the kick in field. Well, here's Laulala off the infield pass from Augustine Pulu. Vaka steps out of the first tackle. New Zealand Sevens representative. They didn't hold him either, so he went again. Well, that's a good determined run from Sam Vaka. He's looking for a good start in the second half. There's the replacement man, Faletau. Now Francis, nice ball back in field. Vainga breaches the first line of defence. Onto the front foot, the kick out to the wing from Pulu. Fafita gets it back in field, and oh, eventually one of the Waikato players, and it's Harrison Levine, gets in the way, cuts off the pass, takes it over the touchline, because the Steelers were threatening right in the opening minutes of the second half.
Well, Levine saves the day there, but once again was just set up by the big Counties forwards, rolling around, and here we go. Just a whisker away from being another try, but they're not out of jail yet.
Well, they go to two-point line-out time. Set it for the drive.
Get out. It's four.
Sua in the back has got the ball in his hands. Over the line he goes. Nafatasi Sua. And the front row domination of the scoring continues for the Steelers. It's their fourth try. Tui Loma might be gone. Sua says, I got this. Fourth try of the night, 27-5.
Well, here we are, not out of jail, as I said. A great take there by Tupou. The maul is set. Everyone heads down, working. They start to splinter the Waikato pack. You see a few boys with their heads in the air from Waikato. They keep low, they keep going, and in the end, it's too easy.
Yeah, very good body position from the Counties Manukau forwards. They just kept going, kept trucking forward. Fatasi Sua tucked in the back, always in control. Very good execution from the set piece. Counties Manukau, and a wonderful start to the second half. Can confirm those Waikato replacements too. TJ Milford Kerasoma, as you mentioned, jersey 23. He's replaced the fullback Tyler Campbell. And Harrison Levine is gone. And halfback replaced in jersey 21 by Pelly Cowley.
Kick no good. And there he is, Tui Loma. Well, big night for him, but unfortunately he ends with a concussion. Well, good to see a smile on his face at last. There's the try scorer. Oh, the restart from Christy Pulu puts it very high. And it's going to come down just inside the half, not taken cleanly by Fetu Douglas. And picked up by Fa'asoo for Counties Manukau. So it was a great kick from Pulu, put it really high. And now here is Taufua. One of those trademark runs of his, tupu, gets rid of it quickly. Little stab kick through for Stowers to get after Reese coming across. And brilliantly. Well, he's unbelievable, this kid. Look at him go. Fires the ball back and big hit. That was Pulu. And referee awards a penalty.
Well, they've been penalised there, but I know I've given Counties forwards a rap, but also I must give the combination of Pulu and Francis a rap. When the forwards do get over the advantage line, the big Counties forwards, then what they're doing, the halves for Counties, are turning the Waikato back around.
Well, that's a great kick from Christy. Very narrow angle. Look at this fellow here. This is Reese. So he ducks under Stowers, steps around another one, and then gets the offload away.
Not bad for a kid that's first year out of school.
Scored three tries already this season. Can't imagine they'll be his last either. Douglas wins the line out. And the drive on him. got a big gap to make up now, Waikato. All goes to ground, but Faiva gets it away. Taufui. And here's the replacement now, Cowley. In fact, it was Cowley was the man who saved that attempted try in the corner just early on. Here he is in action now. Yosefa Scott. Now, Faiva. Working away here, but inevitably the mistake comes.
No.
That to me is the difference between the two teams at the moment. When counties get into the opposition 22, they're high tempo, their forwards are smashing over the advantage line. When Waikato get into the 22, their ruck speed is slow and they're a little bit undecisive.
No, I don't
have to. Here we go, just a lack of communication. A little pick and pop, but who was he popping to? Slapped him on the hand, and then it's a knock on County's ball. And as we've mentioned, Waikato had a few problems scrum time, but if you look over to the sideline, it's only going to get worse when you've got the likes of Hickey Elliott and Manu who are chomping at the bit to come on later on in this half.
Well, I can tell you Hickey Elliott's not too far away, Steve, and he is chomping at the bit. Been on the sidelines for a number of weeks now. It's full of energy, warming up prior to the game, and he just cannot wait to get back out.
Crouch.
The middle here.
You've got two of them, haven't you? Elliott, Poliasi, Manu.
We're going quite early into our crouch position before I
ruptured an Achilles tendon back in March. Here's Hicker Elliott.
In our crouch, please.
Starting his second start with Counties Manukau, or second stint with Counties Manukau. Played for them back in 2013. Actually ended up Poverty Bay for a while in between times, but he just keeps on keeping on, and he's not far away.
Bind. Set.
So Pulu.
Balls to the back.
Oh, Tui Luma might have gone, but the scrum dominance is still there. Waiting for it is Francis. And nicely balanced, gets the kick away, finds a perfect angle. That is what you call a very good exit.
Yeah, and there it is, Tony. There's the power mixed with the precision. And that's what the counties have got. They've got quality 9, quality 10. We've seen the power, and now we saw the precision and the accuracy
subs
by Piers Francis.
And two.
You know, very good kicking percentages over 70, nearly 80% with his kicking.
So just trying to get a substitution on here, Waikato. And they've managed to get Aidan Johnson out there, and they're trying to roll Stephen Misa out. Yeah, they'll both go. Misa, jersey 16, Aidan Johnson on debut from the Haltapu Club in jersey 18. And he's replacing Latu Talakai and Hami Faiva. The hookup, respectively.
Well, Aidan Johnson, one of a number of promising young front rowers coming onto the scene, coming out of the New Zealand schools and age group system.
Time's on.
Look out from jersey 18. Oh, Fifita can't control it though. Line out time. The referee awards a penalty though. So a bit of illegal work, disruptive work. There's a familiar face, Stephen Donald. Apparently the white bait are running well.
I sent him a message before the game, Tony, and told him we'll have a couple up here in the commentary box. He told me you always delivered. I haven't seen anything yet.
Well, I know back in my radio days, Alan Dawson always used to provide the white bait.
He's here tonight, Tony, in the radio commentary, so you might want to reconnect there. Just pop your head next door.
Again, it's messy, and eventually it's been lost forward by Cowley under all sorts of pressure. Real difficulties at set piece time. And back it goes, this time carried back. So he looked to kick it down the middle.
Advantage offside.
Bounce isn't great, but great run here from Halaholo. And again, though, another thumping tackle from Pulu. Taufui now. Douglas got rid of it. Okay, he'll try again. Douglas. Cowley now reaches and fires it away. Christie, little show of the ball. He's taken on the 22.
All of the players here.
Referee's got them offside.
All in front of the kicker.
Well, I don't think there's any point going for the post now. They really have to throw everything at it.
They do. They've got to go sideline also. Well, I've noticed that line-out time. It is very messy, but I just like Fetu Douglas, the captain of Waikato. Every time he calls himself and he goes up, they seem to have a positive result. So I know it's simple, but they really need the ball now. It's time for Fetu Douglas to call himself again because he's had great success.
Well, Halehola was in full flight then, and now that tackle by Augustine Pulu. I doubt there's a halfback in world rugby who hits as hard in the tackle as he does. Douglas wins the line out. And the ball's been lost. I'm afraid that sums a lot up.
Sup.
Yep, Countess Monaco now will make the replacement. Hicker Elliott, Jersey 16, will replace the impressive Nafa Tassisua.
There's not much reprieve in that replacement, is there, Pod?
No, not a lot.
But both the try scorers have left the field now for Counties Manukau. Kalolo Tuiloma off after taking a knock to the head. Nafatasi Sua has done a very good job. Rewarded with a try. And then on comes Hicker Elliott. Four test All Black, 30 years of age. Vast experience.
Crouch. Height. Bind. Set.
Tulu calmly getting things organised and gets the ball off the back from Fa'asoo and runs. And runs hard. Byrne came back and made the tackle. Fired the ball behind him.
Vantage lost forward.
Ball's been turned over here, and Cowley has it now. Pops a nice ball up to Jacobson. Tries to get it away to Misa, the replacement hooker, and he's fighting his way down inside the 22. Cowley Vantage now, over. Short side. Smashing backwards. Onto it was Reese. Left the ball behind, but they carry it on. Now Fifita, as Pulu comes flying at him. Cowley, now Misa. And trying to bash his way between two tacklers, almost did so. Now here's a good carry. To the line they go. I think it's Byrne who's got over here. In fact, it's Brad Tucker, the lock.
It's great reward for Waikato, who persisted with this pick and go, and they've finally got a little bit of reward. We'll have a look on the replay in a minute, but they've kept going. It hasn't always been smooth here. This is a great surge. Get in behind the defensive line, suck a couple of defenders in, and then from there, there was no blind pillar, and he just marched his way to the try line.
Yeah, great option, isn't it? The pick and go directly through the middle, if you can recycle quickly. No defenders there from Counties Manukau. Hicker Elliott went the wrong way, and Tucker saw that, just went chomp, chomp, chomp straight up the middle.
Well, Christie with the attempted conversion, and over. So it's 27-12. Still a long way to go, but that'll just boost their hopes a little. County's making more changes.
Yeah, Onosai Ovard, the very experienced player, jersey 20, replacing Fa'asoo, Sootala Fa'asoo. And Sam Christie in his 50th game, he's done and dusted. His replacement, jersey 22, Jason Robinson.
Christie just getting an encouraging word there from Stephen Donald. And Fa'asoo. Powerful again tonight. Restart has got too much on it.
One area of County's game tonight that hasn't been too clinical is their kickoff. Both kicking the ball off and receiving the ball. There's been quite a few mistakes, but it presents Waikato an opportunity here. As I said, Counties did tire to the end of the first half, and the game's still got a good 25 minutes to go. So if Waikato are going to launch an attack, what a great place to start from. We have seen they do have some exciting backs.
Now Jason Robertson on with the brightly coloured headgear. Severice just right behind the scrum.
Crouch.
Look for him.
Bind.
Got to get the scrum right first.
Set.
Yeah, it's been under pressure all game from this big Counties pack. They've hooked it though, and they take it off the back. Tofui. Reese now taking the infield pass. Just that annoying little kick through that we're seeing so often at the breakdown this year, but no harm done. Tofui. He was very strong last weekend. That's not been controlled, though. Alva'a away to Tupou. And Dao Taufua accelerating. Stowers leaves it behind him. Pulu. Alva'a taking it right on the advantage line. Now Francis moving it on. Elliott with his first carry gets the offload away, too. And then the settling kick from Francis saw a lot of open space. Reese has gone back and won't try anything too flash. Well, the kick certainly wasn't too flash. It's gone out. He might have gained 5 metres of anything with that. So,
goal three.
County's Manukau are going to get an opportunity from an attacking line out here. More changes.
Yeah, 17's getting involved here. 17 for County's Manukau. Puliasi Manu will replace number one, Sean Backshaw. And 17 for Waikato Tau Kaloa Matangi.
But another show of the versatility that Counties have. We've talked about the power, but just the ability to peg them down in the corner, force Waikato to kick the ball out, and here we go. Just about 10 metres out, the big Counties pack have a chance to maul and rumble again.
Toliasi Manu, first game since March when he ruptured that Achilles tendon in training. Elliott with the throw. Taufua had to hang around for a fair while to collect that, but they've got it. And they smuggle it back to Hika Elliott. Heads up, looking around, seeing where the opportunity, where a weak point might be. Can't really find one, so they release it to Pulu. Taken up by Fainga. They start hammering away again. Elliott with the carry, but the referee blows the whistle. Some frustration there from Sione Faletau, thumping the ground. Opportunity not taken.
You saw the intent again. Here we go here. Just a slight little knock on there. Got a little bit too eager. A little bit of white line fever. But you saw the intent again from Counties. They were just trying to roll their big forwards around, punch in. And if the defenders do drift off them, then you've got Pulu there who'll snipe. And we know how powerful that man is.
So a lot of changes now in the front rows. In fact, all change. Tau Kulua Matangi on this side of the scrum.
Crouch.
For Waikato against Manu.
Bind. Set.
You get the feeling that Waikato might be in for a pretty tough scrum here.
Yeah, I get the feeling I can't see him, but I'm getting the feeling as Manu in his comeback game, he's licking his lips a little bit, going up against some pretty green front rowers there. So I think the best thing Waikato can do here is simply get the ball in, a quick hook, Fetu off the back and set a ruck and play off that. I don't think they want the ball in the scrum for any length of period of time.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
So Cowley to put it in. Here's the big shove from the Steelers. But they're penalised. Illegal wheel.
Well, I think that's just the power of Puliasi Manu. Quite simple.
Well, it's a relieving penalty, and I think Waikato might be forced into another change. Let's just have a look at this scrum here.
It's just got penalised, hasn't he, for walking around a little bit, not pushing straight. So, yeah, probably fair enough, I'd say. I'm not trying to be too one-eyed, but he just did walk around a little bit rather than going straight through the middle, so probably fair enough.
Yeah, Waikato keen to make a replacement here. It'll be Tyler Campbell, the fullback that started the game, re-entering the fray, but he's not going to get the opportunity. Waikato have been forced to carry on.
Another untidy line-out, although it's actually been knocked through by County, so they can set it. See what they can get going. Here's their second try scorer, Brad Tucker, taking it up over the 22. Fifita, familiar stride, went again.
Break down his form. Hands in the breakdown.
Well, he's ruled he was part of a breakdown there. He thought he was clear. Picton went again. Here is Tyler Campbell coming back for Willis Halaholo.
It's a marginal one, that one, and it could have gone either way, I suppose. But for Waikato, it's disappointing because it gives the counties a chance just to stretch this lead a little bit.
Just watch it. He just takes that fraction of a second to make his decision here, places the ball, takes his time getting up. By that time, players had arrived, so the breakdown had been formed. Couldn't put his hands in there and continue. Hamstring too is the issue for Willis Halaholo.
Well, that's not good news for Waikato ahead of a Shield game on Wednesday. Francis with the penalty raises the flags. It's 30-12. Another successful kick for Piers Francis. And counties maintain a steady advantage. Here's the restart from Robertson. Gets it nice and high. Rata Asia went up for it. Couldn't get to it though. And well, Burns knocked this back. Some very good work there by the blindside flanker. And he'll go and to help his mate at the clean out too. Misa. Waikato really needing the multiples of five now. Douglas. Reese was in there. I love the way he goes looking for work. Misa puts his head down, charges ahead. County's tried it as rut. Reese. Now he's lost the ball and away comes Tolu. Augustine Tolu. He's got Stowers with him. Oh, good covering tackle made by, I think it was Robertson for Waikato. It was Robertson. He lost the headgear in the process. You can see him there putting it back on. Counties have still got the ball. Now they've got a penalty. It's taken quickly and off goes Talfua. Well, they've hit the turbo button again. Laulala gets away. Nice pass away from Manu. Now, Rarasia, the lock, brilliant offload away. Oh, this is great stuff. Vainga bustling his way towards the line. Wonderful hand-to-hand from County's Manuko. Keeping the ball alive. Great support lines. Pulu gets it away. Laulala just short of the line. Stowers smuggles it away. And they might be over for another one here.
Sorry, time off.
We're going to have a look upstairs, but this is great play, isn't it? Whether it's a try or not, this is great play. It started all the way back by Pulu. And then there's just an interlinking of play between the forwards and the back. It's a great county's movement. If not a try, certainly deserved a try, but we'll take a look and see what we've got from upstairs.
Yeah, just the concern about the grounding here.
No, Glenn Blackwell. It's a Fifita, the right winger. Oh, he's got that down. Sione Fifita. They're all wandering back to halfway. twisting, wriggling, just needs to get it on a blade of grass.
He's made it up out of the seat pretty quickly, TMO, so that's positive for Counties.
We can't let the forwards do all the scoring, I suppose.
Just wait. Yes, Glenn. Thank you.
Yeah, Sione Fifita, try confirmed. It's 35-12 with the kick to come.
Once again, TJ, this started from inaccuracy. Back inside, Waikato attacking inside Counties 22. A turnover happened. Pulu breaks out, and then from there, it's just an interlinking of play between forwards and backs. Great line break here. Gets in behind, sucks a little bit more defence in, and just look, the interlinking of play, the small passes. And then just here, we had to check it, but in the end, no doubt, try. Great Counties try.
Yeah, fabulous try. Just players in all positions just encouraged to stay in support of a ball carrier because they know a pass is likely to be coming. Here's the conversion from Francis, no good. And Waikato, well, two more replacements for then jersey 19. Taylor Ray on debut, Hamilton Old Boys Club. Counties Manukau, they'll also make a replacement. Matt Vai, jersey 19, will replace Jordan Talfua, who's had a very, very good night.
Tom up.
Well, it was a great bust out from Pulu. And how about the pass in the middle of it from Manu? Restart. And it is the try scorer, Fifita Pulu, who has shown his class in every aspect. That's not a good take from Campbell. Just didn't quite get to it.
Two.
He's disappointed with himself.
But once again, just the quality of Pulu. We've seen what he can do around the field with ball in hand. But once again, just putting the pressure back on Waikato. They score points, and now they've got their own scrum feed inside the Waikato
Make sure
half.
Mark's here, guys.
There's Tyler Campbell, made a very good debut. Interesting player. This is, he was an Australian schoolboys player not that long ago. But just didn't perhaps see the opportunities in front of him that he was looking for. He's a New Zealander. He's come back home and scored a try on debut last week. Desperately trying to get to that high ball on the full. Couldn't quite make it. And so it's going to be a Counties Manukau scrum feed. 15 to play and a very handy lead now, 35-12. Take Counties to the top of the table for the moment. Francis has been running things nicely, just dropping passes off, spreading the ball wide when it's on. Pulu has been terrific. Francis floating it wide, sensing the opportunity for Fita. Now Elliott brings it open again. Vaka trying to hold him up, but he's got good strength. Gets it to ground. Francis again. Well, that time went through the hands of Vainga. And it's been snapped up by Robertson for Waikato and a penalty to the Mulus. Stephen, I really like the way in a beaten team, Sevu Reese is, you can see he was right in the thick of that. He's just coming all the time looking for something to do.
Yeah, he's exciting, we know that. And also the thing is, look, any opportunity, you know, and he hasn't had many standing out on the wing, so he's had to come in and look for it. This fella's got this young man's got a bright future. Just on that, TJ, what I'd like to see from the Waikato team now is when they get inside the 22, they've been trying to pick, go. But the county's pack has been too physical for them. I just want them to take a slightly wider channel into the midfield, move the big county's forward pack around, try and tire them out a little bit and make them do a little bit more running. Because the simple pick, go option is just not really working for Waikato at the moment. They're getting monstered by the big county's pack.
Stephen Misa from the Hamilton Marist Club with the throw. And, I think
Sam Vaka there. Yeah. Tony, he's gone from the midfield, replaced jersey 23, Joe Ignacio.
Right. opens the line out. Beg your pardon. Waikato have it. And surging for the line, and I think Misa, the hooker, he's got it over. So Stephen Misa with the try.
It's a great day to be a front rower, isn't it? It's another one for them. So you know, the more paid off in the end. They kept going. It's great body height for them. Then Stephen Misa scores another one for the front row club. Here we go. The ball's taken down. The Waikato team is nice and low. But the thing I like about it is the communication. They keep working together. You can see it there. They're barking at each other. They're talking to each other. They get held up. The body position stays low till eventually it starts breaking up. And then Misa sees a little opportunity to just duck under and crash over for 5 points.
Yeah, he did well, didn't he? Stephen Misa under pressure from Puliasi Manu. Robinson with the conversion attempt.
It was probably Pod, the patience in that maul is the patience that Waikato have probably missed tonight inside the opposition 22.
Well, certainly the antithesis of what we saw in their first attempt at a driving maul from a line out in the first half. Stephen's spot on. There's the pressure from Manu, but Misa stays cool, calm, collected. Gets it across the line.
Well, it was Taylor Ray, the lock, who went up. Good clean line out taken. We haven't seen a lot of those tonight. Gave them the platform. Misa over for the try, 35-19. Yet another try scored by a front rower. Been a benefit. And Francis, this time, having put one over the touchline, kicks it down the middle. Waikato, can they do enough? Maybe close it up, even a bonus point. A couple of tries and a bonus point would be something to show for this match. Good strong run from Tevita Talfui. Finding there's still a little bit of life there. And numbers away on the right too. Knocked back by Sherwin Stowers. You can do that as long as it's back towards your own goal line. And now a penalty against Waikato, much to their frustration.
Well, he's keen, Reece. We just mentioned it earlier on, but perhaps a little bit offside there. But what I do like from Waikato is they gave the ball a little bit of air. They started moving the big county's defenders around, and I liked what I saw. They started to get in behind their advantage line. If it wasn't for a legal, I might add, but a legal slap down, they could have been in there again.
Good run from Byrne, and that's where the ball got knocked back.
It was a good run, but it was nice to see them shifting the defence around, getting in behind, and then trying to use the ball. And you know, if it wasn't up to the defence here, great scrambling defence there, we could have had a different story.
So Elliott with the line out throw. There's Viliami Rarosea. Jimmy Tupo behind him. They've been using Talfua a lot earlier in the game. He's gone now. Tupo. Nice leap from him, very athletic lock. Pulu again, another one of those high kicks. And, Ratuva didn't get anywhere near that. Got it back, though, through Misa. Hard worker. Ray carries it on. Robertson. Strong running from the replacement. First 5-8. Referee's playing advantage, and now... Well, they've split them up the middle. It was Murray Eti with the strong run. Ball's been lost, so they'll come back for the penalty.
Time off. Where's the mark?
Similar to the first half, too. Late in the half, the Waikato team is getting in behind the tiring county's defence.
Nine.
I mean, they've only got 9 minutes to go. They've got a bit of catching up to do. But it's good to see they haven't given up, and they're still using the ball, giving a bit of air.
Just what we talked about at the start of the game. Yep. So if a guy comes through,
I think this game
fully bound to kick the ball.
Starting to take its toll on players from both sides, Stephen. It's been pretty frantic. There's been plenty of ball movement. And again, under these new experimental laws, the pace of the game just goes up a notch.
We're going time on, lads. Just here.
And also, Pod, you've got to remember that both these sides have played in very close contests. We know the Counties have just pipped Auckland in the 78th minute, then they had two last-minute draws, and the Mulus last weekend, a 20-all draw for the Ranfurly Shield, you know. So they've been playing 80-minute games, so there will be a little bit of fatigue out there, and as you said, it's a little bit wet underfoot tonight.
Yep, and Richard Judd, he'll make his way on for Counties Manukau to finish this one out, replacing the impressive Augustine Pulu. And another injury replacement, which Jacobson returning for Waikato.
Well, what a game he's had. Augustine Pulu. Absolute class from him. So it's been a good week for both of these unions at the Under-19 tournament, the Graham Murray Cup, the premiership title at the Under-19s, the Jock Hobbs Under-19 tournament, the Memorial tournament, won by Waikato. Outstanding kicking from Matthew Lansdowne, and Counties Manukau winning the Michael Jones Cup. Douglas knocks it down. Certainly haven't stopped Waikato. The heads haven't gone down. It's been a tough night for them. Here's Misa. He's been tremendous off the bench. Reese always looking to try and start something. They've looked after him pretty well. Now, well, a bit of a hospital pass. That was Manu flying up out of defence. Good carry here and an attempted offload by Douglas. But again, it's a penalty.
Offside.
Let's go up tempo, Waikato. Number? You know, let's go up tempo. Let's get these Counties boys moved around. Let's not slow it down. Let's get up tempo and get in their face. But you said it, Stephen Misa, since he's came on, he's had a great role. He's given the Waikato team a bit of go forward. And while I'm giving a rap out, I must give a rap to the Mulus captain, Fetu Douglas. He's been played in a pack tonight that has been pretty well dominated, but he's had another strong game from the Mulu captain tonight.
Now, Stephen Misa, it is with ball in hand. There is Douglas in the number 8 jersey. They go to Ray, gone through his hands, just a bit overthrown, but they still get it back. Tolfoi picked up on the bounce by Ratuva. He steps back in field. Stow is helping out on the tackle. Now, Cowley. Ray. Johnston, nowhere for him to go. Douglas. Counties, they were asked to tighten up their defence at half time. It's been pretty good. They've given up three tries in this game. High scoring game. We're seeing plenty of those in this competition. Johnston, good footwork from the prop. They're hammering away. They have tended to put each other under pressure with their passing at times. And here's Campbell.
Release 10.
Francis making the tackle on him. And they continue to hammer away. Douglas, who certainly turned in a very honest performance, the skipper tonight. Misa, he's been good. Now Robertson floats it wide. Ratuva stepping back in field. Deep inside the 22 they are now. Iti with the carry. Cowley. Ray. The benches have been cleared. A lot of high numbers. Here's Reese. Trying to side his way through. Good tackle made by Alva'a. But there it is still for Waikato. Campbell determined bid by him to make it to the line for the second week running. Reese picks it up. He's just short. Cowley.
Use it.
Byrne now moves it on. There's an opportunity. Pops it up. Try scored by Jason Robertson. So it's their fourth of the night. They get a bonus point, Waikato. Jason Robertson is the man who scores it.
And just reward for having patience inside the 22. Sometimes they moved it wide, sometimes they kept it close. But here's the man here, Reese, gets him behind again. He's been electric tonight. And then after that, they just feed off it. They finally place it back. And I do like this little behind the back ball that they've used. And here we go, slight little off-road, and we crash over there. But I do really like it when they go in behind. It draws in the county's defense.
Well, it was good reward for Robinson. They were making hard work of that at the end. Waikato, but he looped around after making the initial pass to Robinson and rewarded for his determination to stay in support.
He's about 18 metres in from touch. Chance to convert his own try. Jason Robertson. And a good kick too.
Final substitution for Counties Manukau, Nathan Deteri in jersey 22, and he'll replace Carter Fainga.
Oh, nice moment for Jason Robertson. Picking up the try, announcing his arrival.
Well, 9 points of difference. 4 minutes to go. Great chance for the Waikato team to get 2 bonus points. Well, I think the winner's out of reach, but good chance to pick up a couple of bonus points rather than just one. Let's see what they can do.
Well, here's the restart. They'll throw everything at it. There's Talfui. Cowley.
It's carry back.
Robertson. Reese has a look and, oh gosh, the acceleration there, but it was well read by Rarosia, the lock making the tackle. E.T. Oh, just a few minutes left in the game, but finishing pretty well here, Waikato. Robertson again looking for the infield pass. Cowdy's just looking a bit tired now. Picked up by Misa, who's been dynamic, coming off the bench. Johnston might have left the ball behind though. Yeah. He's lost it. So, Counties have it back. Judd, the former Thames Valley Swamp Fox, thrown on the ground. They'll come back. There was no advantage. It'll be a scrum. There he is, Richard Judd. Second year with Counties Manukau, having made the move from Thames Valley.
They threw everything at them there, didn't they, Waikato? But just probably the story of their night, you know, just the finishing and the small little details in their game just hasn't quite been up to scratch tonight. But they certainly, you can't fault their effort, you know what I mean? They've really had a good crack, and they've stayed tough for against the side that really has at times bullied them around the park a little bit.
Well, I think there's a problem with the halfback here.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether they're concerned about a head knock here or something, but the trainer was quick to get out there and talk to him. And that's certainly what's going to happen. Pulu will sub back in here. He's clearly not happy about the decision, Richard Judd. Yeah, and certainly getting it confirmed that he will head off for a concussion check, but I'm picking by the time that's finished there'll be no time left in this game. So
well, a bit of a blow for Judd. He's been sitting there watching Augustine Pulu give an absolute masterclass tonight. Gets his chance and he's had to go back off the field again.
It is, but it gives us an opportunity to give Pulu another rap. One thing that's really impressed me about Pulu tonight, we all know what a great attacking threat he is, and also can defend, as we've seen tonight. But what's really impressed me about him tonight is the height of his box kicks, just to get his team out of pressure and back down into the Waikato half.
Well, those high kicks too, he puts them up, they go up a long way.
And the Chasers have time to get under it, and they've caused Waikato more than one or two problems tonight.
And of course, he's a player who will have his eyes on an all-black jersey. Pretty hot competition. 4 international quality half-backs and one or two more not far behind them. Pulu. Francis now drops it off to Nathan Thierry's on there in jersey 22. Larosia on the 22. Pulu. Manu. Good to see him back in action tonight. Alva'a. Another one who's brought some real energy to this side. But referee awards a penalty here. Well, Waikato, I thought they've got a, just over a minute here.
Sorry, arm was the wrong way.
There's no point in dying wondering, is there? You might as well throw it around, give us a bit of entertainment and have a crack. Try and pick up extra bonus point.
Well, they'll start with some easy yards first to the sideline from the Buddha Robinson. And they'll get themselves organised on the way to the line out. Misa will get the ball and they'll need to go because there's the full-time hooter.
So one last chance to grab a second bonus point. And remember, this is a tight race for the top four. Every point could count. Misa, well, they got up. Rarasia got up and challenged. And I think counties have got this. Well, Poliasi Manu decides, I'll finish this, I'll have the last say. Well, it's been a night for the props. First and last word, Poliasi Manu thumps it into touch. Remember, the hat-trick by Kalolo Tuiloma. Sensational start to the game, and at the end of it, Counties Manukau have won it by 35 points to 26. Counties Manukau for the moment have gone top of the table in the Mitre 10 Cup Premiership Division. What a night for Kalolo Tuiloma. Ended early, unfortunately, because of a head knock. One name you don't see on the scoreboard, but a man who really turned on an outstanding all-round performance tonight. Augustine Pulu, let's hear from him. He's with Richard Turner.
Well, Augie, another positive 80 minutes for your side tonight.
Yeah, boys play really well, and you know, we just talked about, you know, starting well, and yeah, boys started really well, and credit to them.
How much confidence did you take out of that victory last weekend against Auckland?
Oh, we knew it's gonna be hard, but the boys dug in, and you know, we talked about it's all about us, and you know, we carried on this week, and it's working for us, so we're just gonna keep moving forward.
Very good platform, and good to see those tight forwards getting it across the line.
Yeah, we got a couple of good ball runners, and you know, it's easy for me because our forwards are going forward. So credit to our forwards tonight.
Well, good job tonight. Keep up the good work.
Cheers.
Thanks, man. Appreciate
it. Oh. Well, what a performance from Kalolo Tuiloma, and he scored 3 tries tonight, equaling the record of Brian McGrattan a long time ago, 1984. Let's hear from him.
Well, Kalolo, good night for the boys tonight.
Yeah, no, it's been awesome. It's always good to get a win over, well, now we can call them our little brothers, so, yeah, we have the right to do that. But, yeah, no, credit to all the boys. It was just a team effort, so.
Yeah. Big team effort, but also a pretty big effort from you. 3 tries in that first 40 minutes.
Oh, no, like I said, it was all teamwork, and, yeah, no, I'm just lucky enough to be at the end, so, yeah.
Well, mate, you're obviously enjoying being out there, getting the opportunity, obviously, and playing some pretty good footy.
Yeah, oh no, I love it. Just taking every opportunity I get and taking it with both hands, and I'm loving it out there with the boys, especially a great bunch of county boys. So, yeah.
Well, mate, we're loving watching you out there, so keep up the good work.
Cheers. Thank you.
Cheers,
man. Well, they get a haka for their efforts tonight, too. Counties Manukau, what a night for Tuiloma. Well, here's what we've got ahead of us on Saturday. Well, what a match. Canterbury against Otago. Top of the Premiership Division against top of the Championship Division. And that match in Christchurch. Taranaki, Manawatu to follow. And then Hawke's Bay against Tasman at McLean Park in Napier. That's an all Premiership Division. Then on Sunday, North Harbour against Southland. Of course, Southland got a win on the board this week. Tight turnaround for them. They play North Harbour. And then to wrap up the weekend, Bay of Plenty against an Auckland team needing to bounce back from that loss last week. Bay of Plenty, of course, tough to beat at Rotorua. So that's what's ahead for the rest of the weekend. But a good win tonight for Counties Manukau over Waikato by 35 points to 26 here at Ecolite Stadium in Pukekohe.